1 Corinthians 11 from verse 29. Or maybe I should just start from 23. For I've received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. These do in remembrance of me. After the same manner also he took the cup, when he had supped, saying, the cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as oft as ye drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death till he come. Now let me pause here. Some people say that communion is a Jewish feast and that it's not scriptural for local churches today to take communion. Now listen, that's stupid. That anybody would think that or even preach that, the person is being stupid. The person is being ridiculous. Notice he said, as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death till he comes. Now, is either you are saying the rapture has taken place and he has already come and you have missed the rapture and you're in the dispensation of the tribulation or in the millennial reign of Christ, or you are saying he hasn't yet died. That's what you're saying. Now, Jesus instituted this. Now, I know there was the Passover. I know if you read Exodus 11 and 12, when they were going to leave Egypt that night, God told them to take a lamb without blemish, a year old, you know, and then 14th day and all that, and then slaughter the blood, eat it with bitter herbs, roast it, have their sandals on their feet, their belts girded and all, and put the blood on the lintel, on the doorposts of their houses, and that the angel of death was going to pass by Egypt that night. And everywhere the blood had been applied, the angel was going to pass over that place. And then God now told them, instituted Passover. Yes. Now we know that the Old Testament was types and shadows. The Bible tells us in 1 Corinthians 5:7 that Christ, our Passover, was sacrificed for us. So Jesus Christ is the antitype of that lamb. You know, we are told in John 1:29, behold the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the whole world. So he's that lamb, the Paschal lamb, the substitutionary sacrifice. But you see, Jesus, when he was not going to die, he was trying to get them to see that that type you have been seeing, I am the antitype. I'm the reality. That was shadow. I'm the real deal. He now broke bread just before he died with his disciples. And then he now said, this do in remembrance of me. He now said, as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you do show the Lord's death till he comes. So it's an ordinance that the church needs to partake of. The church needs to keep practicing. Let me also say this. That bread is not Jesus's body. That wine is not his blood. His blood was shed 2,000 years ago. His physical body was broken 2,000 years ago. His spiritual body is the body of Christ today. What is the bread? What is the wine? You know, I've heard people say stuff like, as you eat this bread, as you drink this wine, it becomes the blood of Jesus in your system. Listen, it's bread. Tylenol will start acting on it in your mouth, saliva. Then it gets to your stomach. The enzymes will start acting on it. It's bread and it's wine. There's nothing to the bread. It's not aseje. You know aseje? You go to meet one dibia or one baba. He now gives you this portion. Now say, eat it. Eat everything. You see, we have come from that kind of background. And we almost want to see everything in the light of our background. No, we're not to see the Bible in the light of our background. We're not to put our experience first. We're to put the Word of God first. So it's not that kind of a portion. It's not portion. It's not portion. We've made it portion. We've made it. We now, you know, there's something they call transubstantiation. That the moment the minister prays on the bread, it now becomes Jesus's body. It now becomes Jesus's blood. It's not Jesus's blood. His blood was shed once and for all. Now, what is it? It is a type. It is a symbol. Nothing more than that. Can somebody be healed on the communion table? Yes. Why will he be healed? Because he's saying, Lord Jesus, I understand that this bread represents the fact that your body was broken for me. I understand that this wine represents the fact that your blood was shed for me. I take advantage of what is mine in Christ. On the basis of the finished work of redemption, by the stripes of Jesus, we were healed. And because we were, I was. And because I was, I am. So that's scriptural. And then a believer, let's say he's living in broken fellowship. You know, another thing we say, where the Bible says, he that eateth and drinketh unworthily, eateth and drinketh damnation to himself. We interpret that to say he that eateth and drinketh unworthy. So we say if you're a sinner, don't eat it. Oh, if you're not born again and you eat it, you will die. That's a lie. If you're not born again, come to the communion table. You need to partake of it. And then you can get born again at the communion table. If you're a believer out of fellowship with God, well, who needs a doctor? Is he the well man or a sick man? A sick man. So if you're out of fellowship with God, please come. And then get right with God as you're taking communion. Take advantage of what that blood has provided. Take advantage of what his broken body made available. So don't forget, it's a symbol. We're to do it as often as we can to show the Lord's death until he comes. Amen.